Again, welcome back. In exception handling, we are now moving to learn the keyword finally. Finally is just like a block. We have try block, we have got catch block, and then we also have got a finally block. Now we have learned that if there are some statements which can potentially throw an exception, we should keep them inside try. And then we have also seen that if an exception is thrown inside try, then corresponding catch will be called. The condition is a matching catch is required. And you have also seen chain number ka pana, which is actually the exception class, which will handle, which will match with all types of exceptions. Right. Then there is third block, which they call finally. It will execute after catch block. If there is a catch block, then it will execute after catch block. But you know that execution of catch is conditional. If an exception is there in the try block, only then catch will execute. Otherwise, catch will not execute. Right? Because it is not absolutely necessary that we provide a potential situation and it in any case throw an exception. There might be that we foresee an exception, but at runtime, that exception may not be thrown, because we probably give inputs which are not throwing exception, right? So you know that exception is thrown at the runtime, you are not guaranteed unless we are using keyword true, right? So execution of catch block is kind of optional. If an exception is thrown, then catch block will execute. Otherwise, catch block will not execute, right? But the finally block is a kind of block which will execute in any case. I mean, even if exception is thrown or not, but finally will be executed. Right. Let us learn this with an example. So class finally demo. Right. I have here public static void main string arg. Okay. I need to switch off fan. This must be causing some noise. Okay, so here inside try block. Inside try block, I say that string maybe name. Initially, it is null. Okay, inside this try block, I say system dot out the println. I say hello plus name. Okay, let's even remove this. I don't need it. Okay, name, and here I say zero. Right, so you know that we are trying to refer to command line argument, and you are well aware that if we provide argument, then it will be on zeroth location. But if we do not provide argument, then this is an array index out of bounds exception. Right. I provide a catch for array index out of bounds exception. Right. Okay. I can write here system dot println. I just display E. Right. And then I also provide a finally block. Finally. This finally block will execute no matter if exception is thrown or not. Right. You can see here I say hello, I am finally. Right, so you will see that execution of catch is conditional. If exception is thrown, then catch will be executed and exception will be caught. But if exception is thrown or not thrown, in both cases, finally will be executed. I'll tell you what is the advantage of using finally block, but for the time being, just see its behavior. We have got try, we have got catch, we have got finally, and after finally, right, we are going to write another statement. This is after finally. Right. So we save it, we call it finally demo dot java. Right. Finally demo dot java. Okay, so Java C finally demo dot java. There is one error. We are referring to name, which is not existing because I removed it. So I'm referring to ARG. Okay, CLS. Java C. So you can see it has been compiled. Java finally demo. You can see here. First of all, because an exception has been thrown, so you know this statement is not printed, right? We are catching exception. Because we catch exception, so this message has been displayed. After catch, you can see this finally executed. And because we have caught exception, that is the reason why program has not terminated. We reach to this statement after finally. Right. Okay. Now, let us see what happens when exception is not thrown. Now I write here, Shay. Hello, Shay. Exception has not been thrown, so catch has not been executed. Finally, it is still executed. Hello, I am finally. And then, obviously, because exception has not been thrown, that is the reason why a program has not been terminated. So this is after finally. So you can see execution of catch block is conditional, but execution of finally is guaranteed. It will execute no matter if exception is thrown or not. Right. Now I tell you the power of finally. I mean, sometimes you want to be absolutely sure that some statements are executed no matter exception is thrown or not. For example, you want to close a connection to a file, because in operating system you are will clear that if connection to a file is open and if try block throws an exception, catch is executed, maybe catch is not matched, catch is also not executed, then the connection to the file which you opened inside try may always be opened. So you want to be absolutely sure that this connection should be closed, because if you have opened connection to a file, then operating system will not allow other applications to open connection to the same file, because simultaneous access to the file will actually cause data corruption. So in that case, if you really want to be absolutely sure that certain statement must be executed, whether or not an exception is thrown, then such type of statement must be written in the finally block. Because execution of finally is absolutely guaranteed, whether exception is thrown or not, but execution of finally is always guaranteed. Right. And one more thing. See here, I remove catch block. You know that try cannot live without catch. If you're providing a try block, then you can provide multiple catch blocks, but at least one catch is required. And that requirement is waived off if you are providing a finally block. So you can see here, in this case, I've got a try block. I do not have any catch block. And then I have got a finally block. Obviously, finally will not act like a catch block. When catch block catches exception, program is not terminated. But in this case, because finally will ensure that this statement is executed, but finally will not be able to avoid termination of program execution. It will be terminated here. So obviously any statement which is after finally will not be executed. But the favor that finally is doing, it is that it will provide you a chance to execute some statement which you want to be absolutely sure that they are executed whether or not an exception is thrown. Right. So try cannot live without catch unless there is a finally. Right. So in this case, we are not providing any catch block, but it still it is okay because we have got the finally block. you will see that Java C finally demo, the program has been compiled. But this time, you know that although this statement inside finally will be executed, but finally will not prevent termination of the program, which means that any statement after finally will not be executed. It means this part will not be executed. You can see here, there is no exception. So obviously, finally is still executed. But if there is exception, then see the behavior. Hello, I am finally. It means that exception was generated here. Even then, finally was executed, but then program was terminated. That is the reason why this part was never executed. You can see here, after you know exception thing, you cannot see you know this is after finally. It has not been executed because finally will not prevent termination of the program. Right. So this finally block will actually ensure that if you want to be absolutely certain that few statement must be executed, whether or not exception is thrown, then you must keep those statements inside finally block. And one such example I have told you, connection to a file. Because if you open a connection inside try block, and if inside try block you happen to have a exception which you have not caught, then obviously program will be terminated and connection to the file will remain open. An operating system will not allow other application to open a connection to the same file. So obviously it will cause trouble. So that is the reason why we have got this finally block, which will absolutely ensure that these statements which you want to execute, they should be kept inside finally block. Okay, so this actually completes our set of 5 keywords which are important in exception handling, which is try, catch, throw, then finally. Only 5 keywords, right? When you come back in the next video, we will see built-in exceptions of Java, and then we will also see how to declare our own exception. Thank you very much.